What would you advise the average guy out there who's concerned about himself and his family? Maybe he didn't go crazy in the housing boom. He didn't get a gigantic mortgage. But he wants to know, you know, what to do now.
Well, I'll tell you what I do. We don't give investment advice. I buy gold. It's the only thing. I don't believe in this is a global meltdown. This is a global economic crisis. And all the governments are doing the same thing. They're printing more money, stimulus packages. They're using 1930s models for a 21st century problem. It's insane. And there's not enough money. You know the numbers, $500 trillion in derivatives, you know, that are worthless. So what's $1 million here, $1 trillion here, $1 trillion there? It's nothing. So they're printing money and making it worthless. So I buy gold. I'm protected, you know. I believe that crime is going to go off the scales. Matter of fact, right across the street, we're in Kingston, New York, the capital of the revolution in New York State, and we're right off the most historic corners in the country, the only place where there's a stone building on each corner. Well, the little coffee shop across the street got robbed, petty thievery, you know, they broke in at night. We're going to see more and more of that. It made no sense, this robbery, because the people that are doing it are out of their minds. The country's... We have a growing underclass that we did not have during the Depression. We were an ascending nation. You look at the numbers, and I'm certainly not a classist. I'm a guy that grew up in the Bronx, you know. But you look at the numbers, and you have graduation rates under 50% in high school graduations in major cities. So we're telling people to prepare for the worst. I have my, you know, I'm not a survivalist in the crazy sense. I'm a close combat practitioner. And so, yeah, I have my dried fruits to last me for 2 weeks and water for 2 weeks in case something really, really extraordinary happens. You know, when 9/11 happened, I had an escape plan. I was on my feet ready to move. And this is, people should know. One of the first things I did was I called my bank up to get my money out. You know, I'm a New Yorker. I know this terrain like the back of my hand, and I know where Indian Point nuclear power plant is, and planes are coming down the Hudson River. And if a plane hit the nuclear power plant, there's going to be chaos like nobody had ever seen. So I was ready to go to Canada. And I had my gold, I had my guns, but I didn't have my money. Because I couldn't get out of the Fleet Bank because I had it in CDs. And when I wanted it wire transferred to my local bank, they said, "We're sorry, Mr. Salenti. CDs are financial instruments, and Wall Street is closed." So people should know that if there's a bank holiday, they're not going to get their money out. If they have CDs, they're really not going to be able to get them out. So we're saying to people, it doesn't cost anything to take protective measures. It takes nothing to be alert, to do things that are going to preserve your wealth. And so those are the kind of things that I recommend.
Gerald Salenti, thank you very, very much. I want to urge everybody to take a look at trendsresearch.com. And I certainly agree with Gerald's points about gold, guns, and having some cash in your own possession outside the banking system. Gerald Salenti, thanks a million.
Yeah, thank you.
You've been listening to The Lou Rockwell Show. Produced by LouRockwell.com, the best-read libertarian website in the world. Thanks for listening.